Here we go. Chun Sing Tong to start it off with the serves. Amazing timing, really.
Questionable work from the cameraman there.
Perfection, really. Just from Chun Sing Tong, the same on the table. Takes the first point. Now, we've talked about the preparation for the Chinese national team. The women of Team China have such a strong base and are so quick to recover. Chun Sing Tong, again, just outside the top four, still one of the best in the world. And that's the backhand. That is the flat hit from those short pips. It's going to be tough. It's going to be tough for Chun Sing Tong to rally with. She's just going to do her best to make sure that Miyuki Hata doesn't have a comfortable shot from that backhand side. For example, spins it deep. I feel like this is sort of the key ingredient. Oh, by the way, congratulations to Miyuki Hata for getting her braces removed. It's one of the best feelings in the world for anyone who's ever had braces.
For sure, I had them for 3 years. It was like a new life.
3-2.
Something I've noticed about the Japanese women's team and men's team is the change of physique. Such built legs, I've noticed. Be interesting to see the change in physio team in the last 5 or 6 years. There has been one.
You're saying the Chinese team, men and women, both seem stronger in the legs than they did previously?
No, the Japanese.
Oh, Japanese, I'm sorry.
Yeah. When you look at the legs of Nagasaki, Kihara.
Part of that so might strong. Be genetic as well. I think Miu Nagasaki is pretty exceptionally strong. Even the Chinese team physios talked about Miu Nagasaki for years, saying this is someone who recovers incredibly quickly, someone whose base is very strong. 2 points on the board for Kihara now. And versatile in that backhand this rally. First opening, a bit more spin on the backhand, and then the flatter backhand shot. Here's the opening, and then just a quick short punch.
Yeah, perfectly played. It was a nice wide shovel serve as well at the start.
I mean, it's almost like a metronome out here. Just clockwork as she keeps punching these backhands, and Chun Sing Tong makes it look easy. It's not. Most players would put this ball back into the net because there's not as much topspin on Miyuki Hata's backhand. Tong Tong playing well. Double the score of her opponent. Trying to introduce a little bit of side spin to the rally, Miyuki Hata. That was pretty cool. Sort of caught the ball on the racket, no bounces on the forehand. It's an outstanding serve. She earns herself a decent third ball, but again, the threat of Chun Sing Tong on the other side really puts that extra pressure on.
Nine,
a bit off the top of the net here. And the crowd will be happy to see the national team player from Team China just edging ahead in the score line. 6 of the last 8 points for Tong Tong, and she continues 7 game points now for the world number 7, Chun Sing Tong.
You can see why she's got an 87% win rate against non-Chinese players, Chun Sing Tong. Doesn't look to be fazed whatsoever.
Not fazed, but on to the next phase of this match. It'll be game number 2 with a 1-0 lead. Nice change of pace there with the backhand.
For sure. There still is versatility. Less so probably spin-wise, but placement, just the same.
Relentless play from Chun Sing Tong. All the weapons, the bullets, the arrows, everything that's being thrown at her, she has an answer for. Chun Sing Tong just gliding around behind the table. Look how far apart her feet are.
Yeah.
It's amazing how quickly she resets and can topspin those shots back.
Insane, right? That's the benefit of having someone like He Zhua Zhua in the Chinese national team.
Stop.
Claude Drouin is actually incredibly challenging. There aren't so many players with long pips playing aggressively, much like Deng Yaoping did. Deng Yaoping, the little giant as she was known, 7.5 years at world number one.
Jeez.
Yeah, and she was told she was too short to play for the national team. 4'11". Maybe 149 centimeters for the metric world, which I guess is most of the world. I didn't choose where to be born, I'm just saying. 2 points apiece here after the first four. What? Not even the net shots.
Three.
Nothing is bothering Tong Tong.
She's basically the Kuka robot at this point.
Wow. Even the middle. Racket so high. What do you do against Chun Xing Tong? Kiara, congratulations. You have just entered the next level. This roller was absolutely mind-blowing. And net recovery, watch it just crawl on the table. A caterpillar. Look.
It in the top 10 now.
Oh, man. Oh, beautiful. Oh, I hope her rib cage is okay. She won't get to see it until later. To create art like that and only be able to see it later. Oh, man, it is too good. Oh, man.
That might be better than Patrick Francisco's against Ma Long. I think she had to reach further.
100%. I love Franz. That shot was next level. And an edge to follow. In all fairness, that shot that we just witnessed, it has to be shot of the day.
Yeah, it's the shot of the day.
It was a recovery against her opponent's fortune. She was in a bad position, and she pulled out the shot of the day. Yeah. Zhang Rui watching with physio for the Japanese team, for Miyu Kihara.
It's hard as a commentator to kind of think about what to say after a shot like that, even a few points in, because we're still in that just amazement mode.
For me, it just goes to show you that these players are capable of anything.
No.
I mean, it makes me sad when someone says machine in response to anyone out here at this level, especially the Chinese national team. The point is, they're not making many mistakes. They've worked incredibly hard to be consistent, to reduce errors. And on the Japanese side as well. But when called for, I mean, Fan Zhendong showed us, he was the first one to hit a shot anything like that that went so viral under the net clamp, a roller. And Miyu Kihara, the first time we've seen her try in this match, did it successfully under pressure.
It's basically zero bounce to that roll at all. It was just like, you know, just got onto the playing surface.
Definitely a low shot, a low roller indeed. But Chun Xing Tong back in front. Service warning here.
Below the playing surface.
I love it. Tong Tong just saying, okay.
6-5.
Got it. The warning was you can't dip the ball below the playing surface of the table before tossing it. Ooh, questionable.
5-7.
It's interesting. It's very subtle. I think our umpire has been outstanding at enforcing the rules. She's really noticed the details in a way that I think others haven't.
5-8.
I don't know about you, but if I had to guess, making that first shot a little bit extra quality, take your chances to put more pressure on. And if it goes in, you've got your opponent a little bit more behind the table, a bit more wiggle room and angular advantage.
It just bemuses me that Chun Xing Tong's getting the balls out of the middle. I was just about to say, Kihara maybe wants to switch down the line or into the middle a little bit sooner. Because Tong Tong's such a rhythmic player and she's battling really well in that department of the game. Man.
Stop. 9-6.
Good serve placement there. Shovel serve to the forehand side. Asking Miyu Kihara either to flick with that forehand or to play a backhand from the forehand side. But the momentum with Chun Xing Tong, 6 of the last 8.
7, 9.
Do you recall any player doing the shovel serve as regularly as Muharano? Because for me, it was when she broke through in that 2017 Asian Champs that the Chinese seemed to take a lot of aspects of that serve.
I think of it as something that the Chinese team started.
Okay.
I mean, for me, it's just in the women's game.
10.
Team China has tended to set the trends, as Chun Xingtong has score-wise here with 3 game points. But yeah, that shovel serve is incredibly common within China. And a nice save of game point, but many of the women seem to follow from Japan. Yu Hirano, Mima Ito's done her fair share. But I mean, it's quite common. Kasumi does it. Miyu Kihata does it. I mean, find me a Japanese player who doesn't. Or a Chinese player who doesn't at this point. 10 serving 8. 2 game points left for Tong Tong. And the kick, 11, the shovel 8. Serve with side Tong, and topspin Tong, makes Tong. A second bounce. Nice long, change of pace here from Miyu Kihata. Funny, I was thinking, I don't know how much you're thinking about what Miyu Kihata could do. But yeah, I guess that's the main question right now.
Yeah. She can definitely get at least a game here. Oh, yeah. Beautiful.
This is a very interesting combination, just thinking about what she can do. She comes out here, plays soft. A little bit of a mini chop block deep, soft backhand, and then the rocket. It's a rhythm-changing shot, or pattern, you could say.
So well done there.
Lock.
But I just can't imagine seeing this trend of points continue throughout the entirety of the match. I feel like the Chinese adapted after Ito broke through, and now the Japanese have to adapt again if they are to cause more problems. We see them doing it in the receive with their strawberry flicks and whatnot, but...
It's easier said than done. I think that... Yeah, if you're going to beat the best in the world, you're not going to beat them in their own game. You're going to have to bring something that's unfamiliar. But in some senses, shortcuts to success aren't necessarily long-lasting. If it's just a gimmick, it'll be overcome. Well, now, what a save. Both players have had this opportunity, and that lick of the lips was Chun Xingtong saying, I could have cracked that ball, but I played a touch shot. And again, it's only hindsight. It seemed like an outstanding, clever idea. But Miyu Kihata with a wonderful recovery to come back in. And just to clarify, gimmick might be a strong sort of, I don't know, not to take credit from anyone who uses shots that are unconventional. It can be an incredible way to play, and we see it from some of the best in the world. But China... Team China works so hard to overcome.
4-3.
To beat the Chinese, though, I feel like it just takes something slightly different. Something more unusual.
Like Jules Morgard?
Yeah, for example. Just look now. The trend didn't continue. Chen Shintong found this rhythm, got used to it. She's so good at adapting to rhythm, isn't she?
You know,
something I think she's so good at.
I'd say the person with the most rhythm-breaking game in the women's game, at least in the top 50 or so, Monica Batra, who got the best of Chun Xingtong at the end of last year at the Asian Cup.
Good point. Very good point.
It's not so common to see Chun Xingtong being beaten by a non-Chinese player. Monica Batra of India, the golden girl, took a bronze medal at the Asian Cup. Oh, crushing forehand here, that flick. But I do think that when you play for Team China and you have a loss to a foreigner or any unusual style, there's a lot of conversation and a lot of work to make sure that you come back to the table even better prepared.
I guess Monica's win there kind of... I guess it kind of proves mine and your point in a way, that it takes something different to beat them, but... Even someone who's good at adapting like Chen Xingtong can lose.
So 7 of the last 8 points from that adaptable player on screen, Tong Tong. It's a shame. She just got her braces off, but there haven't been so many opportunities to show the teeth.
A four. A four.
Nervously watching in the corner, Coach Nakazawa, Miyuki Hata's coach.
Let. A four.
Man, her eyes are incredible. Our head umpire here, the umpire for the match.
A five.
Pressure here, some parallel shots from Miyuki Hata. Again, it's now or never, game number three. Miyuki Hata must win every game for the rest of this match to survive and move on to the round of 16.
Six, eight. Six, nine.
Some of the tactics we've seen from Kahara have been good. Trying to go backhand a couple of times, then into the middle. She has attempted the switch, but Chen Shintong just has that extra zip.
And now it is four match points. I mean, you're right, tactics, that's a big part of the battle out here. When you're playing someone who's simply stronger, better prepared, even the best tactics might not succeed for you.
10-7.
And a timeout here from Chen Shintong. We shall see three match points. Nice change of pace after a marathon rally. Miyuki Hata takes all the pace off with a very slow shot off the backhand. I mean, she had rockets in this point. Just can't wait to see that last shot. There it was, how shallow it was on the table, too.
Be quite brave to slow things down, actually. In those kind of moments. Couldn't bite the bait. Chen Shintong there.
And there it is, Chen Shintong, 11-8 in three straight games, takes down the 18-year-old world-ranked number 18, Miyuki Hata of Japan.